अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई एम डॉक्टर अब्दुल वहाब, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मेसी, कोहाट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई एम इंस्ट्रक्टर फॉर द कोर्स कम्युनिटी फार्मेसी, PHR 518। आवर टुडे टॉपिक इज कंट्रोल ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज, कंट्रोल ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज। So as you can see over here, discussion outlines. In our today topic, we will cover drug abuse, classification of abused drugs, symptom of drug abuse, effects of drug abuse, reasons of drug abuse, control of drug abuse. So these are the different topics for our today discussion. We will try to cover all these topics. Drug abuse. So before going to define drug abuse, is according to the definition of drugs, that what is drug? The drug is the agent which is used for the prevention, treatment and diagnosis purpose, or diagnosis of any disease. So drug abuse is if the drug is used other than main purpose, for example diagnosis, treatment and prevention of diseases, then we can use the term drug abuse. So how can we define drug abuse? So here is the definition of drug abuse: the use of a drug for a purpose other than that for which it is normally prescribed or recommended. As I told you that mostly the drug is prescribed are recommended for the prevention, diagnosis and treatment purpose of any disease, but if the drug is used other than that for which it is normally prescribed or recommended, so we can use in such type of situation the term drug abuse. Or the consumption of the drug without medical authorization, medical authorization that has the capacity to alter the mood or behavior is called drug abuse. According to the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, when a person takes a prescription drug to get a pleasant or euphoric feeling, means to get high, especially at higher doses than prescribed, that is an example of drug abuse. Here one another example of drug abuse, for example, using hydralin cough syrup for causing sedation at night. If anybody uses hydralin cough syrup for the sedation purpose for inducing sleep at night, then we can say that it is a drug abuse, because hydralin cough syrup is not for the sedation purpose, not for the inducing sleep, it is for the coughing purpose. Classification of abused drugs. What are those drugs which are mostly people abusing? Sorry. For example, CNS stimulants. These are the drugs which are mostly abused by the people. For example, cocaine, amphetamines, etc. These are the examples of CNS stimulants. Similarly, सीएनएस डिप्रेसेंट्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल हेरोइन, ओपियम, बारबिट्यूरेट्स, ट्रांकुलाइजर, बेंजोडाइजेपिन्स सच एज वेलियम, जेनेक्स, दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सीएनएस डिप्रेशन. सो दीज आर द ड्रग्स विच आर मोस्टली एब्यूज बाई द पीपल. सो वी कैन से एब्यूज ड्रग्स, दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एब्यूज ड्रग्स. सिमिलरली ओपियड पेन किलर्स, दीज आर ऑल्सो एब्यूज बाई द पीपल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मॉर्फिन, कोडीन, निकोटीन. सिमिलरली हेलोसिनोजेंस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मिरिजुआना, हशेश. नॉन ओपियड पेन किलर्स, नॉन ओपियड पेन किलर्स, दिस आर ऑल्सो एब्यूज बाई द पीपल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल नॉन स्टेरॉयडल एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी ड्रग्स, ड्रग्स फॉर इंक्रीजिंग मसल मास, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एनाबॉलिक स्टेरॉयड्स, ह्यूमन हार्मोन्स. सो दीज आर ऑल दूज ड्रग्स विच आर एब्यूज बाई द पीपल्स. मोस्टली द पीपल यूज दीज ड्रग्स अदर देन मेन पर्पज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल डायग्नोसिस, प्रिवेंशन एंड ट्रीटमेंट. सो दीज आर द मेन ड्रग्स विच आर एब्यूज बाई द पीपल. सो कॉमनली यूज एब्यूज ड्रग्स, मोस्ट फ्रिक्वेंटली एब्यूज क्लासेज ऑफ ड्रग्स आर अल्कोहल, एम्फेटामाइंस, बारबिट्यूरेट, बेंजोडाइजेपिन्स, कोकेन, ओपियम अल्कलाइड्स, एनाबॉलिक स्टेरॉइड्स, पेन किलर्स. सिम्टम्स ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज, हाउ कैन वी आइडेंटिफाई द ड्रग एब्यूजर्स? वट आर द डिफरेंट सिम्टम्स ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूजर्स? आर वी कैन से दूस पीपल आर दूस पेशेंट्स हु आर यूजिंग ड्रग्स अदर देन मेन पर्पज. सो देर आर डिफरेंट साइन एंड सिम्टम ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज. दीज इंक्लूड बिहेवियरल सिम्टम्स ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज, सोशल सिम्टम्स ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज एंड फिजिकल सिम्टम्स ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज. सो दीज आर द थ्री डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑफ सिम्टम्स आर साइंस ऑफ ड्रग एब्यूज. बिकॉज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज सिम्टम्स वी कैन इजिली आइडेंटिफाई द ड्रग एब्यूजर्स. बिहेवियर सिम्टम्स, दीज इंक्लूड एंग्री आउटबर्स्ट, सडन मूड चेंजेस, अनयूजुअल इरिटेबिलिटी और एग्रेशन, टॉकिंग इनकोहेरेंटली और मेकिंग इनअप्रोप्रिएट रिमार्क्स, अ टेंडेंसी टू बिकम कन्फ्यूज, रिस्की बिहेवियर सच एज ड्राइविंग अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ ड्रग्स, सेक्रेटिव और सस्पिशियस बिहेवियर सच एज फ्रीक्वेंट और ट्रिप्स टू रेस्ट रूम, बेसमेंट और अदर आइसोलेटेड एरियाज फॉर प्राइवेसी वाइल यूजिंग ड्रग्स. सिमिलरली बिहेवियर सिम्टम्स, दिस इंक्लूड डिटेरियोरेशन ऑफ फिजिकल अपेरेंस एंड ग्रूमिंग, फ्रीक्वेंट एब्सेंसेस फ्रॉम वर्क और स्कूल, पोर टाइम कीपिंग, neglect of family responsibility, or deterioration in relation with colleagues, customers, or management, evidence of money problem, frequent borrowing, stealing possessions, or stealing items from employers, home, or school, dishonesty, sorry, legal problems such as arrest for driving under the influence of drugs. Social symptoms, these include abandoning or spending less time in activities such as hobbies, sports, and social activities, inability to relax or have fun without doing drugs, associating with non-drug abusers and dropping friends who don't use drugs. Talking about drugs all the time and encouraging others to use. Physical symptoms. These include frequent exhaustion or weakness, unexplained injuries and infection, blackout, become unconscious, flashbacks, delusions. These are the physical symptoms of drug abusers. Effect of drug abuse. What are the different effects of drug abuse? Effect of drug abuse are categorized as general effects, neurological effects, and physical effects. So first of all, we will discuss the general effects. General effects of drug abuse are poor power balance and coordination, confusion and impaired reaction time, sleepiness, anxiety and aggression. Neurological effects. Neurological effects of drugs abuse are impaired memory and learning ability, poor concentration, confusion, panic attacks, seizures, depressions, impaired motor functions. And physical effects of drug abuse are changes in heart rate and BP, nausea and vomiting, loss of appetite, abnormal weight loss, increased body temperature, danger to heart, liver and kidney, chest pain, stomach cramps, hormonal changes. These are the physical effects of drug abuse. Causes of drug abuse. So there are different causes of drug abuse. Among the possible causes of drug abuse are mental illness, depression, low self-esteem, lack of coping mechanism, lack of supporting system, bad role models, pressure of school, work or family tension, etc., poverty and backwardness, unemployment, wish to get high. Thus, in order to escape from realities of life, the people tend to become to abuse the drugs. To abuse the drugs. Control of drug abuse. So there are some of the approaches to control or prevent drug abuse. For example, patient concern, parental concerns, harm reductions, shift resources into programs that work, make treatment available on request like any other health service, investing in youth, community education, legal approaches. So these are the different approaches on the basis of which we can easily control drug abuse. We can easily control the drug abuse. Parental concern. So first of all, we will discuss about the parental concerns. The most effective form of preventing the drug abuse appears to be stable family. Appears to be stable family. Parents need to be aware of the power they have to influence the development of their kids throughout their teenage years. Parents should not be afraid to talk directly to their kids about drug use, even if they have had problem with drugs or alcohol themselves. Parental concerns. Parents should clear no use message about drugs, smoking and alcohol. Parents should also be involved actually and demonstrate interest in their teens, friends and social activities. Spending quality time with teens एंड सेटिंग गुड एग्जाम्पल्स आर एसेंशियल फॉर प्रिवेंटिंग ड्रग एब्यूज, हार्म रिडक्शन. हार्म रिडक्शन रेफर्स टू पॉलिसीज, प्रोग्राम्स एंड प्रैक्टिसेस दैट एम टू रिड्यूस द हार्म एसोसिएटेड विद द यूज ऑफ साइको एक्टिव ड्रग्स इन पीपल अनएबल और अनविलिंग टू स्टॉप. The defining features are the focus on the prevention of harm rather than on the prevention of drug use itself and the focus on the people who continue to use drugs. Techniques include education to avoid overdose, needle exchange programs to reduce the spread of blood-borne diseases, etc. The philosophy of harm reduction accepts that drugs use is a part of the community and that it must be addressed as public health issue rather than a criminal issue. Shift resources into programs. Most governments take drug abuse as a law enforcing issue. In USA, 2/3 of the federal drug control budget continues to go to incarceration, interdictions, and law enforcing programs, while treatment, prevention, research, and education driving the remaining third. The government must shift to treat drug abuse as a health problem rather than as a law enforcement problem. Availability of treatment. Making treatment services widely available weakens the drug market and reduces the harm for drug abuse. Treatment also needs to be user-friendly. The best way is to allow people who need treatment to choose it, rather than law enforcement choosing treatment for people who happen to get caught. Availability. Treatment. The basic aims of the treatment are: assess the patient to remain healthy until they can achieve a drug-free life. Reduce the use of illegal or non-prescribed drugs by individuals. Community education. It is also the approach for controlling the abuse of drug. It is an effective approach to control the drug abuse, to educate the community about the harms of drug abuse. Media can play an important role in this regard. For example, electronic media, print media, and social media. Investing in youth. The most effective way to prevent teenage drug abuse is to invest in youth and keep them interested and involved in life. Government should increase after school programs like skill building and job training program to keep youth away from drug abuse. Legal approaches. Most governments have designed legislation to criminalize certain types of drugs. These drugs are often called as illegal drugs. So the unlicensed production, distribution, and possession of these drugs is also illegal. Even for simple possession, legal punishment can be quite severe, including death penalty in some countries. So it was all about the today topic. So thank you so much. Inshallah, we will discuss in our coming lectures about the drug addictions. Thank you so much. God bless you.